So hi everyone, and thanks already for introducing the topic of my talk, and also thanks for Lina to explain all the things we did for the germination and the proof now we have in vivo germination. As you see on this slide, germination is really key to justify all the mode of action of our probiotic right after the production of metabolite and etc. So that's why it was the really key step of the storytelling of our probiotic. So you see it on that side that having also a look to the metabolite produced by Malterion, it's an indirect methodology to also prove in vivo that indeed the bacillus germinates. And also the metabolite will have function and effect and could explain all the mode of action we explore on Alterion, including nutrient utilization, effect on the host, on inflammation and gut barrier, and also on microbiota. And those, of course, at the end, and this is the conclusion of my talk, will have, of course, a beneficial effect on the performance and welfare of the animal. So if I start by summarizing what we have found about the production of a metabolite, so we have an in vitro and in vivo approach to identify and to quantify the different metabolites produced by Alterion. And we, of course, we combine the two results to make it robust and to now be able to show that some of the metabolites are really key for the effect of the probiotic and our produce is in a consistent way. So if I start by the first one, niacin. Niacin was also produced in vitro and in vivo, as I said, in the different section of the gut, in jejunum and yellow, and you can see on the graph on the top end corner of the slide that the concentration of this metabolite is really linked with the growth of bacillus into the gut, meaning that the presence of Alterion will impact the concentration of niacin. And then after that, to also to know the metabolite is one thing, but we to understand what is the real effect and function of the metabolite is also nice to see. And we develop in vitro models internally and also with some scientific collaboration to see if there was an impact on inflammation, on restoring the gut lesions that happens in some of the challenge in the field, and also having an effect on gut barrier. And you can see here that the summary of the finding for niacin was to have some effect, significant effect on inflammation, reducing inflammation, and also reinforcing the way to reduce the gut lesion following coccidiosis or something like this. The second one identify and produce in very significant amount in the different conditions was hypoxanthine, and also we correlate the production of hypoxanthine with the presence of Alterion into the gut. And hypoxanthine is quite an interesting one because it have a very a broad effect on inflammation, restoring gut lesion, and also reinforcing the gut barrier. So this key component is really important in different pathways. That's why you have a large spectrum of action. And the third one we wanted also to share the way that Alterion is also producing another B vitamin like pantothenate, vitamin B5, and pantothenate is also besides its role of vitamin, of course, have a gut health effect, and we identified this gut health effect that is complementary to the B5 provided by the feed on gut lesion, and also referencing the gut barrier, make the barrier stronger. So in that figure, you will have, the summary of all the findings around the metabolite, saying that we have in vitro, in vivo approach to identify three key metabolites having a significant effect at the gut level. And these three metabolites are strongly involved in the three main parameters that at the end reinforce the gut health, decreasing inflammation, improving gut barrier, and restoring gut lesion. So the next step now is also to see what would be the effect, so through the metabolite, of course, when the spores have germinated, on the three line of defenses. Starting from the microbiota, of course, and then I will go through the gut barrier and also the control of inflammation. So if I move on to the first topic, that microbiota, we have published in the recent years a series of trials showing that adding Altarion to the feed, cementing to the birds, will have an impact, beneficial impact, on the global population of bacteria present in the intestine. And this significant shift is linked to some of bacteria having a positive effect at the gut level. So you can see in the graph this increase or decrease depending on the bacteria, and some of them are very well known to break down, for example, polysaccharides to oligosaccharides, meaning that complex sugar would be destroyed by this bacteria to more simple sugar to be available, accessible for the animal to bring energy, of course, and have also an impact on different other population of bacteria. And the thing also interesting is that population that had been changing by the supplementation of Altarion could also produce butyrate, and I think everybody knows the beneficial effect impact of butyrate. This molecule is really key for gut health, and we have demonstrated that the Altarion could at the end increase the population able to produce butyrate. Butyrate would be a source of energy for the enterocytes, putting in more efficacy at the gut barrier, and also butyrate. There is many reports in literature that is really well known to control immunity, inflammation. So this is a beneficial shift of the microbiota induced by the presence of Altarion, and the consequence of that will be also to keep the homeostasis of the intestine. What does that mean? That means that this shift of bacteria will create an unfavorable environment for the development of harmful bacteria. So we keep a balance into the different population present in the gut, and then that could be also interesting to see that dysbiosis that could be defined at the disbalance of the different population of the gut would be controlled by the presence of Altarion, and this would ensure the microbial ecosystem to be still diverse and good enough to resist to any kind of challenge that the birds could have at the field level. So now move on to the second line of defenses, so-called the gut barrier. So I just have one slide to summarize many collaboration, many years of research. Of course, everything is not in that, but most important messages are here. Knowing that why it's important to reinforce the gut barrier during the production cycle, there will be a lot of challenges that the broiler will be faced, coming from the environment, coming from the feed also, etc. And these different challenges could, at the end, make the gut barrier less strange. So that's why it's important to reinforce, to have some indicators to reinforce this gut barrier. And we have done some exploration of that, starting from the picture you have on the left. When you add Altarion, you can see that the fluorescence would be there will be much more intensity when you add Altarion. That means you reinforce the expression of the protein involved in reinforcing the gut barrier. This is also the same case in the picture of the middle. You can see that, there is an improvement of histological aspects when you had Altarion. That means the erythrocyte would be stronger, would be have a turnover rate accelerated by Altarion, so be more efficient to absorb nutrients, and also the surface of absorption would be higher with the addition of Altarion, and at the end provide more energy to the animal. And then on the right, this is a graph that summarizes the in vitro approach we have to mimic standard or challenge condition inducing inflammation. and measuring the TER, transepithelial resistance, that is an indirect indicator of gut barrier strengthness. And you can see that when we compare the addition of Alterion to control, in the two cases, in challenge or standard condition, Alterion will improve at the end these indicators of tears. That means that the enterocyte will be stronger together and be not susceptible to let some bacteria, pathogens, or toxin enter the blood cycle and make the infection. So that's why it's important to have an effect at this level of the barrier. And if I move now to the third line of defenses, so having some explanation at the what happened at the inflammatory response and immunity, it's quite a complex slide, but I mean the message is quite clear. I mean that when there is some inflammation at the gut level, there is some mechanism at the cells level that will produce some component, enzymes or cytokines, whatever, that will increase inflammation, and this inflammation will induce an immune response after. But that inflammation costs a lot of energy for the animal, so having components or gut cells product could control this production of inflammatory pro-inflammatory compounds could of course at the end make more energy for the boiler to make muscles and performance. So that's why on the two graph on the right part of the slide we observe the secretion of two pro-inflammatory compounds like iNOS. It's an enzyme involved in the inflammatory pathway, and Alterion aim to decrease this production. And the same conclusion for IL-8, that is a really key cytokines in the inflammation pathway. And in standard or challenge condition, we are able to see any decrease of the secretion of IL-8. So that means there is a global impact of Alterion through their metabolites, of course. So if I come back to this, my first slide, just showing it as an introduction, we put the finger, as did not present, on germination, proving that the spore we put in the feed became active into the gut. And by being active into the gut, it can produce metabolite, and this metabolite will have, of course, an effect on different parameters of gut health that could justify its mode of action, and at the end, the increase of performance and welfare of the animal. Having said that, we have conducted in the last few months a compilation of different trials, in vivo trials we did, by comparing the effect of Alterion as an alternative to AGP. And you can see on the output of this meta-analysis is to say that when you give Alterion to the feed to the broilers, they will. The feed intake will not increase, so that means the effect is not coming from an higher feed intake, it's come from what happened at the gut level. And you can see that, of course, body weight and feed conversion ratio will be increased. So that's why today we consider that Alterion is really a consistent alternative to antibiotic, because the mode of action are really proved as an antibiotic was reported in literature, and also in terms of performance, that is the final parameter interesting for customers, to be also as good as HGPs. So in my last slide, a summary of message, of course you have seen that it's important to reinforce the resilience of the animals to different challenges, and Alterion through the different mode of action based on the metabolite it produces, and also with an efficient germination, can improve this resilience and stay keep the animal at the homeostasis to resist to different challenges. Alterion can improve gut health and then performance and welfare, and then we at the end we can ensure that to reduce medication in the field for sustainable poultry production. And it's also nice to take the opportunity of this press conference to thank all the people involved in this midterm, long-term research done with the partnership Adisseo and Ozambu. And we also include the Ghent University in Belgium because we did a lot of things with this with really well-known and reference research team there. Thanks for your attention, and I will be pleased, of course, to answer any question you may have.